गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक. एज यू ऑल नो, वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर 2, मेथड्स ऑफ साइकोलॉजिकल इंक्वायरी इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो, एंड वी वर डिस्कसिंग गोल्स ऑफ साइकोलॉजिकल इंक्वायरी. इन दैट डिस्क्रिप्शन, फर्स्ट गोल वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, दैट इज इन साइकोलॉजिकल स्टडी वी अटेम्प्ट टू डिस्क्राइब अ बिहेवियर और अ फिनोमिना एज एक्यूरेटली as possible. This helps in differentiating a particular behavior from other behaviors. That is description. Second goal is prediction. The second goal of scientific inquiry is prediction of behavior. If you are able to understand and describe the behavior accurately, you come to know the relationship of a particular behavior with other types of behaviors, events or phenomena. You can then forecast that under certain condition, this particular behavior may occur within a certain margin of error. For example, here I am giving an example on the basis of study. A researcher is able to establish a positive relationship between the amount of study time and the achievement in different subjects. Later, if you come to know that a particular child devotes more time for study, you can predict that the child is likely to get good marks in the examination. Prediction becomes more accurate with the increase in number of persons observed. Next goal is explanation. The third goal of psychological inquiry is to know the causal factors or determinants of behavior. Psychologists are primarily interested in knowing the factor that make behavior occur. Also, what are the conditions under which a particular behavior does not occur? For example, what makes some children more attentive in the class? And why some children devote less time for study as compared to others? Thus, this goal is concerned with identifying the determinants or antecedent conditions that led to a particular behavior. And antecedent condition of the behavior being studied so that the cause-effect relationship between two variables or events could be established. That is third goal. Fourth one is control. If you are able to explain why a particular behavior occurs, you can control antecedent condition. Control refers to three things: making a particular behavior happen, reducing it, and enhancing it. For example, you can allow the number of hours devoted to study to be the same, or you can reduce them, or there may be increase in the study hours. The change brought about in behavior by psychological treatment in terms of therapy in persons, this is a good example of control. Next and the last goal, final goal of scientific inquiry is to bring about positive changes in the lives of people. So psychological research is conducted to solve problems in various settings. Because of these efforts, the quality of life is a major concern of psychologists. For example, applications of yoga, meditation help to reduce stress, increasing efficiency. Scientific inquiry is also conducted to develop new theories or constructs, which leads to further research. So, these are some goals of psychological inquiry. Next time, we will discuss steps in conducting scientific inquiry. So, that's it for today. Thank you.